Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the line by line explanation of the chapter Ranga's Marriage from class 11 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. This story is written by Masti Venkatesha Iyengar. He was also a popular writer in Kannada language. He was the fourth among Kannada writers to be honored with the Jnanpith Award, the highest literary honor conferred in India. Let's move on to the chapter now. This story is about a conflict that runs around tradition and modernity. This conflict occurs in the mind of Ranga, the hero of the story, against his beliefs on marriage. He actually falls in love with an 11-year-old girl, and finally let's see what happens to him. Ranga, the accountant's son, is one of the rare breed among the village folk who has been to the city to pursue his studies. So the story revolves around a young man called Ranga, and he is the son of an accountant. He's a rare breed in the village folk because nobody in the village has gone out or has studied any further. But this boy managed to go out of the village and he had done his higher studies. So that's why he's called as a rare breed. When he returns to his village from the city of Bangalore, the crowds mill around his house to see whether he has changed or not. So it is very uncommon for people to go out of their village and study. But this boy Ranga went out of his village. He went to the city of Bangalore for his higher studies. And when he came back after his studies, people crowded around his house. People mill around his house means they come and surround his house. They crowd around his house and they all want to have a glimpse of Ranga. They want to see if there is any change in him or not, because he left the village and was in the city for some time. So it is natural for the village folk to come and see if their boy has had any change. His ideas about marriage are now quite different, or are they? So the narrator is asking us a question whether the ideas that Ranga had about marriage are different or are they the same till now. When you see the title, some of you may ask, Ranga's Marriage? Why not Ranganatha Vivaha or Ranganatha Vijaya? Well, I know I could have used some other mouth-filling one like Jagannatha Vijaya or Gita Girija Kalyana. But then, this is not about Jagannatha's victory or Girija's wedding. So, the writer is talking about why he chose such a name for this story. What's the name of the story? It is Ranga's Marriage. So, he's saying that it has nothing to do with Jagannatha or Girija or whatever. So, he's telling that its story is about only Ranga and how Ranga got married. So, that is why he had to choose this name. It's about our own Ranga's marriage and hence no fancy title. So he's saying that the story is about how Ranga got married. That's why he did not want to keep any other fancy title for the story. Hosahalli is our village. So the story is happening in a village called Hosahalli. You must have heard of it. No, what a pity. But if it's not your fault, there is no mention of it in any geography book. So the narrator is asking the readers if you have come across this name. And he is saying that there is no mention of this name in any geography book also. So maybe most of you may not have heard of this. Those sahibs in England writing in English probably do not know that such place exists and so makes no mention of it. So he is saying that people who wrote this book, especially the Britishers, he's telling that they wrote this book and those people never knew that such a place existed. So they did not mention the name of this place, Hosahalli, in any of the books. So that is why most of you do not know that there exists a place called Hosahalli. Our own people too forgot about it. That means even Indians forgot to write about this place called Hosahalli. You know how it is, they are like a flock of sheep. One sheep walks into a pit, the rest blindly follow it. So he's saying that the Indians are just like a flock of sheep, because if one sheep go in one direction, all the whole flock follows in that direction. So he says this because the Britishers did not mention it, so the Indians who followed them and who started writing books also copied what they did. Because they didn't write, these people also did not mention it. When both the Sahibs in England and our own geographers have not referred to it, you cannot expect the poor cartographer to remember to put it on the map, can you? So he's saying that when those people, when the Britishers as well as the Indian writers forgot to put this name on the maps, then how can the poor cartographer, who is a cartographer? One who makes maps. So when he makes a map of this India or Mysore or Karnataka or whatever, how can he remember that there is such a place? Because it was not mentioned earlier. So you cannot expect this name to be on the map. So there is not even the shadow of our village on any map. So he is saying that not even a bit of mention is made of Hosahalli on any map. Sorry, I started somewhere and then went off in another direction. So he was just talking and started straying from the topic. So if the state of Mysore is to Bharat Varsha what the sweet Kariga Dabu is to a festive meal, then Hosahalli is to Mysore state what the filling is to Kariga Dabu. So he is saying that how important Mysore is to India. Bharat Varsha means India. In the same way, Hosahalli is a village and it is very important to the state of Mysore. Just like the sweet Kariga Dabu, and it's very important for the festival. And he's saying more important is the filling inside. So similarly, the village Hosahalli is also very important in the state of Mysore. What I have said is absolutely true, believe me. So what he's saying that? What he said is true. What is the truth? He is saying that Hosahalli is very important in the state of Mysore. I will not object to your questioning it, but I will stick to my opinion. So I am not only the one who speaks glowingly of Hosahalli. So he is saying that it's not only me who speaks about Hosahalli in a very great manner. Everybody who knows about Hosahalli loves this village and they speak so well about this village. We have a doctor in our place. His name is Gundabatta. He agrees with me. Then he talks about a doctor from Hosahalli and he tells us that even the doctor is of the same opinion about Hosahalli. He has been to quite a few places, no, not to England. So the writer tells us that this doctor has travelled to a lot of places but not to England. If anyone asks him whether he has been there, he says, "No, Anaya, I have left that to you." So he is telling us that if anybody asks the doctor why you didn't go to England, he would tell us that no, I am not going there, I leave it to you. So running around like a flea pestered dog is not for me. So he says that how a dog, if suppose it is surrounded by fleas, it will be it will feel restless and start running here and there. So he does not want to be like a dog like that. He does not want to travel to different places. I have seen a few places in my time though. So he is saying that I have seen a quite few places and that is enough for me. As a matter of fact, he has seen many. And the narrator adds that the doctor has seen many places. We have some mango trees in our village. Come visit us and I will give you a raw mango from one of them. So he is glorifying his village, Hosahalli. Now he is telling that there are some mangoes in his village and he is asking us to visit his place so that he will give us some raw mangoes. Do not eat it, just take a bite. The soreness is sure to go straight to your Brahmarandhra. So I once took one such fruit home and a chutney was made of it. All of us ate it. So he is saying that you cannot eat the whole mango. If you take one bite, that is enough. It goes straight to your Brahmarandhra. Brahmarandhra is believed to be the crown of your head. So the soreness just hits straight onto your head. It is so sour, that's what he tries to say. So he's saying that once he had taken one fruit home, a raw mango, and made a chutney of it, and the whole family had eaten it. The cough we suffered from after that, it was when I went for the cough medicine that the doctor told me about the special quality of the fruit. So he's saying that after eating the chutney, because of the sourness, he had to cough and cough like anything, and he had to take the cough medicine. And then he went to the doctor, and then the doctor explained to him about the quality of this mango fruit. just as the mango is special, so everything else around our village. So we have a creeper growing in the ever so fine water of the village pond. So he is trying to tell us that just like the mango, how different it is from other mangoes, everything in Hosahalli is special. And then he is talking about a creeper growing in the village pond. But enough, if any one of you would like to visit us, drop me a line. So he is saying that enough is enough, I have told you more than what is needed about my village. So if you want to visit here, please let me know, I will come and take you. So I will let you know where Hosahalli is and what things are like here. The best way of getting to know a place is to visit it, don't you agree? So he is saying that if you want to come here, I will help you. And the best thing is how you can know a place is by visiting. Only if you visit a place, you will know how good it is or how bad it is. So what I am going to tell you is something that happened 10 years ago. So now he is telling us, he is going to tell us a story that happened some 10 years ago. We did not have many people who knew English then. Our village accountant was the first one who had enough courage to send his son to Bangalore to study. So he is saying that 10 years ago, not many people in the village knew English, and people were not ready to send their children abroad or to other places for studying. Only the accountant, there was an accountant in the village, and he sent his son first for the first time to the city of Bangalore for higher studies. It is different now. There are many who know English, but he is saying that now the situation is different. There are many people who know English. During the holidays, you come across them on every street talking in English. So what he is telling is about the current situation. Now you can see so many people walking about the streets talking English, especially during the vacation. But 10 years ago, that was not the situation. Nobody knew English, only very few people knew how to talk in English. Those days we did not speak in English, nor did we bring English words while talking in Kannada. So he is saying 10 years ago people did not know to speak English, and they never, obviously, so they cannot use English words while talking in Kannada as well. What has happened is disgraceful, believe me. The other day I was in Rama Rao's house when they brought a bundle of firewood. Rama Rao's son came out to pay for it. Then he is talking about an incident that happened. He is saying that one day he had gone to Rama Rao's house, and then in that house somebody had bought a bundle of firewood, and then Rama Rao's son came to pay for the firewood. He asked the woman, "How much should I give you?" 4 pais, she said. The boy told her that he did not have any change and asked her to come the next morning. So he saw this incident happening in front of him. What happened? A woman bought a bundle of firewood and she left it there, and she asked the money. She wanted 4 pais for it. And then this boy told her that, "I don't have any change." So the word change was English. So the poor woman did not understand the word change and went away muttering to herself, "I too did not know." So what happened? That lady who came to give the firewood, a poor worker, she did not know the meaning of the word change. So she muttered something to herself. Probably she cursed him or something. She was worried or something, and she just spoke something to herself and went away because she did not understand the meaning of the word change. The narrator says that I too did not know. So he also did not understand what was the meaning of the word change. Later, when I went to Ranga's house and asked him, I understood what it meant. So later he went to Ranga's house and asked him the meaning of the word change. The priceless commodity, the English language, was not so widespread in our village a decade ago. So he is saying that 10 years ago the meaning of the word change, or even the use of English, was not at all widespread. Nobody knew how to use English language. That is why Ranga's homecoming was a great event. So that is why people consider Ranga coming back from his higher studies as a great event. People rushed to his doorstep announcing, "The accountant's son has come." So what happened when Ranga finished his studies from Bangalore and came back home? All the people rushed to his house. They wanted to have a look at Ranga to see if he has changed a bit or what. So they all said, "The accountant's son has come." So his father is an accountant. So that's why they say, "The accountant's son has come." The boy who had gone to Bangalore for his studies is here, it seems. So what did the people say? The boy who went to Bangalore for studying has come back. And come, Ranga is here. Let's go and have a look. So people all started saying, come, he has come. Let's go and have a look at Ranga. Attracted by the crowd, I too went and stood in the courtyard and asked, why have all these people come? There is no performing monkey here. So when all the people rushed to Ranga's house to see him, I too wanted to know what is happening. So I also went and stood in the courtyard of his house. What is courtyard? The front open space. And then I asked everyone, why are so many people standing here? Is there any performing monkey or what? A boy, a fellow without brains, said loud enough for everyone to hear, what are you doing here then? So what happened? He's saying that another boy, he's calling him a boy without brains because he questioned him. He asked him, then what are you doing here? Because he asked everyone, is there any performing monkey? So the boy in turn is asking him a question, then why are you standing here? So youngster, immature and without any manners. So he calls him a boy without any manners because he happened to question him. Thinking that all these things were now of the past, I kept quiet. Seeing so many people there, Ranga came out with a smile on his face. So now what happened? The narrator did not want to speak because he just wanted to have a glimpse of Ranga. So as he was standing there, Ranga came out with a smile on his face. Who is Ranga? Ranga is the boy who went out of the village to the city of Bangalore for his higher studies. He finished his studies and came back. So people are here waiting to have a glimpse of Ranga. Had we all gone inside, the place would have turned into what people call the black hole of Calcutta. So what is this black hole of Calcutta? It was actually a dungeon in Calcutta measuring just 4 into 5 feet in which the British prisoners were held. So it was so small space and they were all dumped inside. So he's saying that if all these people who were crowded outside Ranga's house would go into his house, it would have become similar to this black hole of Calcutta. Thank God it did not. Everyone was surprised to see that Ranga was the same as he had been 6 months ago when he had first left our village. So when Ranga came out and smiled, people all were happy because he was exactly the same and he had not changed a bit. So they were all happy to see Ranga. I hope you liked today's video. Let's look at the next part of this lesson in my next video. For more informative videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.